Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on temperature, stress and strain. And for that purpose here we have a question. Whatever is given in this question, I'll write that in the form of data first. Let us get started. Steel rod 10 mm in diameter, so D is 10 mm and 2 meter in length, so it is 2000 mm. Is at 25 degrees Celsius initial temperature T1. Then find the new length of the rod. New length of the rod, I'll denote it by delta L1. If the temperature is raised to 70 degrees Celsius, that is after 25 degrees Celsius, the temperature goes on to 70 degrees Celsius. Find the magnitude and nature of force required to prevent this expansion. We have to also calculate the force, or we can say it is nothing but the reaction force. So force F, which is required to prevent the expansion. They have given us the values, Young's modulus, 2 into 10 raised to 5, and coefficient of thermal expansion and contraction. So with the data available, let us try to get the solution to this problem. Now in the solution, since it is given that there is a steel rod, so I'll draw the cross section. Steel rod is having diameter D. So I'll say that since cross section area of steel rod is given by A is equal to pi by 4 into D square. So that becomes pi by 4 into 10 square, and it is 78.54 mm square. Next, after getting the cross section area, here we have to find out the new length of the rod. And as we can see in the problem, the rod is heated, that is initial temperature was 25, final is 70 degrees Celsius. So this steel rod, whose original length is capital L, it is being heated, and once it is heated, its length will increase. So this is the free expansion denoted by delta L. So if we have total length, in that we add the free expansion, that will indicate the new length of the steel rod. So for that I'll say that now, since free expansion of the steel rod is given by delta L is equal to alpha into delta T multiplied by L. So therefore delta L is equal to alpha is 12 into 10 raised to minus 6, delta T, change in temperature, 70 minus 25, that is final minus initial temperature, into the length of the rod is 2000 mm. So from this I'll get the answer of deflection, which comes out to be 1.08 mm. Now after getting this deflection, in the question it is mentioned to calculate the new length of the rod. So I'll say that therefore new length of the rod is given by delta L1 is equal to the original length plus delta L. So therefore, delta L1 is, the original length was 2000 mm plus delta L is 1.08. So from this, the answer of delta L1, it comes out to be 2001.08 mm. So that is the first answer. That is, we have found out the new length of the rod, and this new length, as we can see, original length was 2000, now it is 2001.08. so therefore we can say that there is an increase in length of the rod. So now, after getting this, the next part is to calculate the nature of force required to prevent this expansion, because here, as we can see in the diagram, if we are heating the metal rod, it will expand freely, but if we provide a wall here, and that will avoid the free expansion. So after this, I can say that now, if the free expansion of the rod is prevented, then there will be temperature stresses and strain developed in the rod. So first I'll calculate the value of the temperature strain. So therefore, temperature strain E is equal to, it is alpha into delta T. So therefore, E is equal to, alpha is 12 into 10 raised to minus 6, delta T is 70 minus 25. So from this, I'll get the answer of thermal strain or temperature strain, which is 5.4 into 10 raised to minus 4. After getting the value of temperature strain, I can say that therefore, temperature stress is given by sigma is equal to strain into Young's modulus. So therefore, sigma is equal to, strain is 5.4 into 10 raised to minus 4. Young's modulus, the value is 2 into 10 raised to 5 given. So from this, I'll get the value of stress, and it is 108 Newton per mm square. After getting the value of thermal stress, now the question was to calculate the reaction, or we can say the force applied which prevents the free expansion. So we have to find out the nature of the force required to prevent this expansion. So I'll say that now, therefore, stress, as we know, it is equal to force upon area . So therefore, force is equal to stress into area. Stress is 108. Area, we have found out, area was 78.54. So from this, we are getting F value as 8.48 into 10 raised to 3 Newton, or we can say it is 8.48 kilonewton. So this is the second answer. So here they have told us to find the nature of force required to prevent this expansion. So if I can explain this with the help of a diagram, suppose there is this rod having length L, and if it is allowed to expand freely, the deflection is delta L. And now if we want to prevent this expansion, then we have to apply a compressive force to this rod, and that compressive force may be in the form of two walls which are attached on either side of the rod. Because of that, it won't be able to expand freely. So therefore, I'll write down the nature of force is compressive. And once we have found out the nature of force, we can say that we have answered both the question, that is the new length of the rod and the force acting. And with this, we complete the question.